Planning Commission of the City of Daly City meeting for February 7th, 2017. Would you all rise and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
May we have a roll call?
Tallarico?
Present.
Satori?
Present.
Crump?
Present.
All right, Ms.
Would you like to speak now, Ray?
Yes.
Okay.
Good evening. In as much as we are going to have the organization, I would like to cite with all my heart the former Commissioner Howard Edelman for an outstanding being a planning commissioner for almost 10 years. And I move to propose that Howard Edelman be given by this commission for outstanding performance, and he be given, because he has given his time and effort without any reservation, and he contributed a lot of ideas, design, and plans as an output to this commission. You will notice that for past 10 years, as a former commissioner, we have a lot of development going on in the city. So this, we cannot just close our eyes and say, we have to recognize him, Mr. Chairman. So with this, I would like to say that we recognize him in the next meeting and ask him to speak here before us, just to say thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, and I second Mr. Satori's comments. Howard did a yeoman's job for us and for the city for a long time. At this point in time, I would like to invite the Vice Mayor to come forward and swear in the two new commissioners, beginning with Pam DiGiovanni.
Thank you, Chair Crump, for the opportunity. Unfortunately, our mayor is at another event, and I'm here and really humbled and honored to do the oath-taking for both Pamela DiGiovanni and for Roderick Maguel. And so I'm here, and you know, as a planning commissioner, it's really a lot of heart and dedication around, you know, community development. And so really honored to do this evening. And so Pamela, raise your right hand. All right. So I state your name.
I, Pamela DiGiovanni.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and defend.
That I will support and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance.
To the Constitution of the United States.
To the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
And to the Constitution of the State of California.
That I take this obligation freely.
And that I take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservation.
Without any mental reservation.
Or purpose of evasion.
Or purpose of evasion.
And that I will well.
And that I will well.
And faithfully discharge.
And faithfully discharge.
The duties upon which I am about to enter.
The duties upon which I'm about to enter. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Well, actually, I just take a moment to thank Vice Mayor and everyone in the audience tonight that came to support both of us, and look forward to working with the seasoned commissioners up here, and had a great experience of a great orientation by the staff. That's fantastic in Daly City. We have a lot to be proud of and to be a part of this, and look forward to doing great things together. And I know that we can come to a consensus and make things a positive in our city that we love so much in this great diverse community. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Commissioner. Roderick, I'm probably going to absolutely mess up your name, but I'm going to take a shot at it. Roderick Mouse Daus Mug Bual. Okay. Close enough for government work.
And I just heard that this is probably the most people at a swearing in for a planning commission meeting ever.
Ever.
So this is a lot of community here. So I'm very honored to do this. I know, our mayor couldn't be here, and also council member Ray Ventura, but I'm really honored and humbled to do this. So raise your right hand. I state your name.
I, Roderick Das Mengbo.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and defend.
That I will support and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
Against all enemies.
Against all enemies.
Foreign and domestic.
Foreign and domestic.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance.
And bear true faith to allegiance.
To the Constitution of the United States.
To the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
That I take this obligation freely.
That I take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservation.
Without any mental reservation.
Or purpose of evasion.
And purpose of evasion.
And that I will well.
And I, what?
And that I will well.
And I do well.
And that I will well.
And I, and I do.
And that I will well.
And that I will well.
Yes.
Yes.
There you go.
And faithfully discharge.
And faithfully discharge.
The duties upon which.
And the duties upon which.
I am about to enter.
I'm about to enter.
Congratulations.
Thank you. My daughter threw me off. She had like her little fake camera, and I was like, oh my God, what are you doing? And my goddaughter. But I just want to say thank you for the commissioner. Thank you to Vice Mayor Jesselyn. I want to thank for all the folks that came out here. I want all the folks. Dr. Allison Tintian-Kubalis. Don here? Okay. In spirit, I guess one thing that I learned from Dawn, she, as educators, we really do take history to our practice. And one thing that she taught me was this understanding of don't be part of the process in times of protest, right? Don't wait until protest when we're trying to get into the process. And I want to be a symbol of that, that we've got to be able to be part of the process before it gets to times of protest, especially times of today. So it's really important for me to be in these positions that, you know, one of y'all could be on one of these positions and represent Daly City to the fullest. So thank y'all.
Thank you, Commissioner. I don't really know.
I'll say Roderick.
Yeah, Rod. Rod.
What is he
going to
do?
Roll call again.
DiGiovanni, Tallarico,
present.
Satori,
present.
Das Magwal,
here.
Crump,
present. Moving right along, the chair will entertain nominations for chair for the next year. Tallarico,
I would like to nominate Mr. Crump as chairman for the next year.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any other nominations? All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Thank you.
Woo!
The chair will entertain nominations for vice chair for the coming year. Mr. Tallarico.
I would like to nominate our new person, Pam, since she's one of the few women I've seen on the Planning Commission, to give us a chance to give us a new insight. So I'd like to nominate Pam as vice chair.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Any other nominations? There being none, all those in favor of Pam DiGiovanni as vice chair?
Aye.
Aye. Pam?
Aye. Thank you.
I'll make sure I miss a meeting so you can sit here.
Okay.
Are there any additions or corrections to the minutes of December 6, 2016? Can I have a motion to approve those minutes?
Motion.
Do I have a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Moving right along to the public hearing. Number one, use permit, UPR 615. I agree completely.
Yes.
11014 and design review, DR 615, 11015. Mr. Von Lunkhausen.
Thank you, Honorable Chair. Members of the Planning Commission, before you in this item is a request for a building addition for to an existing building on Mission Street located at 7322 and 7330 Mission Street. The request involves turning a building that is presently a retail assembly use building into a expanded retail use with apartments, and so a use permit and design review is required for the application. The project is located generally southwest of the intersection of Mission Street and Vail Street. The outline in the yellow shows the proposed site location. This is a photo of the site looking to the west. The subject parcel is that which is shown and outlined by the arrow here. We may be coming back to this picture. Something that's important to note at this point is the shared driveway that the existing property, actually the property line goes between the subject property and the property to the north, goes right down the center of this drive aisle, which would be a one-way drive aisle under the proposal. So the applicant is actually proposing to largely keep the structural, the structures that are here, but add on to them and make architectural changes to them. The building here would become one story taller, and you'll see what that's going to look like. So the existing site is again on Mission Street. For those of you familiar with Mission Street, it's generally characterized by retail, service commercial type of establishments at this location. The subject building is on the right side of this photograph, and we just provided this photograph to show you. There's auto repair, general retail type uses in the vicinity of the project. On the rear of the project, or at the rear of the project, to the west are existing largely single-family residential structures, a neighborhood essentially, and so this is a photo of that. This slide shows the existing site in its current condition. Again, this is the building that would be, again, the structure largely kept intact but added onto. Again, it's not too hard to see that, you know, an upgrade to this building is probably a good thing. The property owner has been working with the city staff for over a year on how to achieve bringing this building into some conformance with the parking regulations, mm-hmm. as well as making modifications to the building to improve its appearance. And so we finally arrived at a project that the city staff and the applicant are happy with, presenting that, of course. Project overview is to expand an existing retail and office building, and there's assembly use that also goes on in the building to include three attached apartment units. Each one of the apartments would be located on each one of the three floors of the building. And we'll go over the floor plan in a moment. The retail space would be expanded to 716 square feet. The, again, three two-bedroom apartments, as well as site improvements that would occur. So at the rear of the project site is a parking lot, and there would be landscaping, restriping, a trash enclosure, and that's shown in the site plan. So this is the proposed site plan. Again, the to orient everybody, this is Mission Street where the arrow is, and this is that shared driveway that I'd mentioned a few moments ago in the site photograph. It's a shared one-way driveway, and again, this line right here is the property line, and the shared driveway provides access to parking, a whole bunch of parking that already exists, actually, that serves what is a dentist's office to the north side, which is in this building. And their parking spaces aren't shown on the site plan, but this driveway provides access. And so that driveway needs to be retained in its current configuration. The driveway itself is presently 14 feet wide, so it's not actually wide enough for two cars to pass by each other.
That's hilarious.
So the city actually has currently a policy which allows one-way drive aisles so long as they don't provide access to more than, I believe, it's 25 parking spaces. And so we have allowed this one-way driveway to continue. You may have noticed in the conditions of approval that the staff has recommended a couple of items that the applicant secure, and the applicant has had discussions with this adjacent property owner, but needs to, prior to the submittal for a building permit, needs to secure an easement on the property that's adjacent to the north. And the applicant's indicated to the city staff that the owner to the north is applicable, or amicable rather, to granting this easement. And so we've made it a, recommended it be a condition of approval in the Planning Commission packet. A couple of other changes to the site plan is we are recommending that landscaping be introduced at this location on the north side of the building. And the purpose of that is that this would be with a raised curb so that cars don't strike the building. It would also provide an aesthetic benefit at that location as well. We've also recommended that the landscaping that's proposed at the north side actually be continued into what is this trash enclosure area. So the trash enclosure would be a little smaller and replaced by landscaping to provide a buffer from the trash enclosure to the residential uses that exist to the west. So those are some of the changes to the site plan that we've recommended. The, as indicated in the staff report, 8 parking spaces are required. This is a mixed-use building, so there's a parking calculation that's provided in the staff report as to how many spaces are required based on the bedroom count of the units and the retail proposed. 9 parking spaces are proposed. So it's actually overparked by a parking space, which is, you know, a good thing. We've worked through some of the handicap access to the building, making sure that cars can back up and exit onto Mission Street moving forward. That is also a city policy and requirement. Initially, there was a larger project that was proposed, as discussed in the staff report, and we did have to scale that back to make sure that all the parking functioned in the way that we needed it to have, again, vehicles moving forward onto Mission Street. So that's the site plan in summation. There's an, maybe one little last thing. There's an open space area here situated to the south side of the building. The, each of the apartments actually provides a balcony, but it's not large enough to completely satisfy the city's open space requirement, which is 150 square feet per unit. And so some of that's gonna need to be provided in improved common area at this location.
May I just interject, ask now while we're here, it's fresh.
Yep.
This one way in and out is a very unique situation. If looking at it, I would hope there would be a concave mirror so that the people coming this way will be seeing traffic, because I have a similar problem in my church. So, in other words, a forewarning so that we don't get jammed in the middle and see a fight on who's going to back up first. Number two, coming out to the pedestrian way, they're going to come out. There should be a speed bump to make sure that they're not coming out. I mean, I'm suggesting a speed bump to slow coming out and a possible light or bell, because pedestrians are going by. These are just, I don't know if you've reviewed those.
You know, the speed bump idea is something we could take a look at.
Yeah.
Usually the bell we reserve for buildings that have a parking garage. So, but the speed bump idea is something that we could take a look at, as well as
the concave and this mirror, see, it gives you a before I come out.
So where would the mirror?
I would say on the corner, on the front corner there, and then as soon as I take a left, you know, those they're like angled and whatever, and you can see that somebody's coming.
Are you
volunteering?
Are you amending the conditions to include these items?
I don't know. Is that what it
would
have to be?
In your motion, you just need to include that you know, speed bump that the city staff takes.
Mr. Chairman, I think there's no need for that, because I know that place. The other place is my dentist. And every now and then, it's going on. So you don't need to do that. I oppose to that, Your Honor. Because that's the end. It's only only complicating your matters. Besides, Mr. Chairman, currently, what's the building for?
Currently, the building's used largely for assembly uses, I believe. The existing, the building that's...
So you're going to demolish the whole building?
No, the whole building's not being demolished. It's actually largely being kept. It's just a third floor is being added and some architectural
modifications. Because I understand this building is a halfway?
Let's actually take a look at the
halfway house, something like that. I don't
know. I think that there may be a use like that in that's situated inside it. Yes. I don't know if it's a halfway house. I think that there is some counseling.
At this point in time, it might serve as to have you finish, Michael.
Sure. So
open it up, Mr. Chairman. That's why I'm asking. So yeah, why did you entertain it? You should better be right in your procedure here, Mr. Chairman.
Mm-hmm. So the screen shows the building floor plan at the first and second floors, and this is, it's hard to read, of course, but I'll walk you through it. This is the retail space here, and this is the Mission Street sidewalk, and pedestrian entrance into the retail space. So on the first floor, there would be a residential unit. So a portion of the building would be converted to the residential unit. And then at the second floor, another residential unit. And this area is just open volume in the retail space. And then in the third floor, another residential unit. So each of the residential units has two bedrooms, full dining room, kitchen, et cetera. They also have a rear staircase that leads to the parking lot here, as well as a front staircase that leads to the Mission Street sidewalk. The screen shows the building elevations, showing the proposed architectural changes again. So the building would, the existing building atop at this location would be demolished and replaced by a second floor with a third floor architectural change to the building that is actually best. We can come back to the slide if anybody has questions about any of the four elevations of the building. Best shown here, this slide actually easier to read. The proposed front of the building would receive a new stucco coat, paint, trim material. When we looked at this building at the initial application, it was that portion of the building that we really felt needed to be embellished, and the architect has worked with the city staff to do that. So that's what's going on here. So this is the staircase that leads from Mission Street entrance to the second floor unit here. And there's a patio here. And then it actually doesn't show here, but there's actually another staircase that goes right behind this wall leading to the unit, the third floor unit. The architecture of this building is something that we worked with the applicant closely on. We wanted to make sure that what we were recommending for approval was something that would be a benefit to the Mission Street streetscape, and we do think that we've arrived at that. We've offered a couple of conditions of approval for just beefing up some of the trim, requiring some of these posts just get a little thicker, trying to accentuate the entrance to the building. And we do think that with those conditions of approval, we can recommend approval. This was the area here that we were talking about adding that little landscape strip to. So this would receive a 24-inch landscape strip. That would bring that drive aisle down to 12 feet from curb to curb, and that is the minimum. Yep. But we do think that that's an important thing to add on. Yeah. So that's the architecture in a nutshell. Gable roofs, at this location, these locations. I do think that that would be a strong architectural feature. I like it. So in considering the use permit, the Planning Commission, this is our typical slide for use permit consideration. The Planning Commission needs to consider what the context of the proposed use is, given the existing adjacent uses, and as we pointed out, there's residential to the west, and we're always sensitive to residential land uses. The applicants actually worked with us to develop a landscape planting along that back fence. We're proposing that it be extended behind the trash enclosure. Planning Commission's charged with taking a look at utility and infrastructure capability. All of those things are in place actually to serve the building in its proposed size. Parking vehicle egress, cars accessing the site, we've discussed that. We think that we're at a point where parking and vehicle circulation on site can work. Staff recommends the Planning Commission take the following actions: adopt the findings outlined in the staff report, affirm the categorical exemption from CEQA, and recommend that the City Council approve the use permit and design review. If there are any questions, we'd be happy to answer them.
At this point in time, I'd like to invite Commissioner Satori to continue with his remarks.
Well, actually, I'm just reacting to what has been said, because I understand this building is used to be the halfway house. I understand. So if you're going to not, the current building will not be demolished, right?
That's correct.
My understanding is, how about the structure, putting up another floor? So how will it affect the structure of this building?
Right. Well, the building, actually the architect's here and possibly could answer some of those questions, but the structural changes that are proposed to the building will undergo, of course, a thorough review by the building and fire departments. Our plan checkers will make sure that the building foundation is substantial enough to take the additional weight of the third floor, as well as, you know, the structural members underneath the addition. So there's a whole separate process from the use.
That's what we were asking here. What will be the process on that?
Would you like us to call the architect forward?
Why not? So just to clarify everything here.
Would the architect come forward, please? Yeah, that's a good one.
This is Leonardo Rodada. He's the project architect.
I'm here to be swearing in. Okay, my name is Leonardo Rodada.
Could you speak up, sir?
Hello? My name is Leonardo Rodada. I'm supposed to be the architect of record for this job. And to address, I guess, the structure, so the existing building, we have to keep that, the footprint. So it's up to the structural engineer to come up with the design, because we're adding two more floors to make up the three story. So that's their job.
Mm-hmm. No, what do you mean does make up? Do you think it will not affect the structure, especially the weight of
I'm not up? An engineer. So
Who are you?
I'm the architect, that's what I said.
So my question is not answered here, Your Honor. This is an architect, he's not a structural engineer.
Okay, we submitted a drawing, which is only for your permit.
Land use entitlement, yeah.
So it comes out, it comes later, soon as prove it.
You know, Mr. Chairman, this hearing is because the moment it gets out of our hand, we don't have any more control on this. It goes to the other pace, like goes to the city council. And that's why we are here, trying to analyze things as a planning commissioner. We're trying to see to it that the moment it goes up, this is already fine-tuned. This is already, at least more or less, we have all the answers ready. That is why we are here. We are not here just to display or just grab positions here or just to make some pro forma here. We are here to analyze things. We are not just here to propagate ourselves.
Of course not. No. But understandably, the question was asked concerning the weight, and I think it has been answered. One, it was structural engineer. Secondly, it's not a planning. That is part of the permit process. Mm-hmm. That's and right. Therefore, as it goes
Why
through,
are you the one answering, Mr. Chairman? Let him answer it. Why are you doing it?
I think it's very obvious that it's already answered, which is in my mind. And we've been coordinating this with the planning department for already a year. And
the building division has actually given some preliminary review to mm-hmm. this plan and has not indicated that it's an infeasible proposal at all. So there has been some preliminary review on behalf of the building division.
Well, you know, this is the dynamics of the public hearing. You know, you ask questions, whether it's incisive, whether it's impertinent. We need some answer here. We are not here just to
I believe that we've answered it as well as we can.
But you are the one answering, not him.
I am not an engineer, excuse me.
He has said he's not an engineer, I cannot. Commissioner Satori. Thank you. Thank you, gentlemen. Oh, we appreciate it.
Thank you.
Anything further,
through the
Commissioner?
Chair, just a little ramification. To get to this point, the plans have to come in to the building plan.
That's right.
If at any moment the building planning, building inspectors notice a structural difference, it won't get to this point.
That's right.
So if we've already gone through this, because I had worked with the
that's right.
program in developing that. So the checks and balances is
that's right.
Okay. I mean, that's
to get to this point, the city's building division, the fire department, the engineering division,
police,
water, wastewater, they've all taken a look at the proposal.
So we let everybody know it's
they've issued conditions of approval that are included in the staff report.
Okay. Well, we know that, Mr. Chairman, you know, that's a process. It's a tedious process, but it will go through that. But when we are here in the Planning Commission, we're asking questions. We are not here really just to ask you this question. We are here to more or less to validate all those information that has been given. Otherwise, what are we here? We just stop this meeting and just let them approve it based on the records, right?
Excuse me, if you want, we can give you the design of the engineer, structural engineer, and it's up to you to analyze the
Mr. Chairman, I'm not talking here about myself. This is really for general interest, public interest. So people will know it, especially the layman. You know, I'm not here just to ask questions, Mr. Chairman. You know,
right.
Based on the viewpoint of the layman, a lot of people complaining about traffic, parking, and this is same thing. If this might collapse eventually, then who will be blamed here?
Well, again, I would have to ask the structural engineer because I can't answer that. Thank you. Do you have any questions?
I guess my curiosity is, I believe that structure will be part of, it's gonna be like a residence, right? So is there a process of like who will have access to living in those properties? Will there be affordable housing options?
Hmm. The number of units that are proposed mm-hmm. rather are fewer than the minimum mm-hmm. or that require okay. affordable housing, which I believe is five.
Yes, the minimum requirement is five units.
Yeah.
So this is below that threshold.
Anything else?
Wouldn't be like a chance.
The lady a chance.
Come on.
Any questions,
yeah,
ma'am?
No, through the chair, I just wanted to make a comment on I don't know if this is at this time, but I do support, the reason I support the speed bump is for our physically challenged and seniors in our community. There's a lot of walk traffic on that area. And if it is viable to do the speed bump, I'm in support of the speed bump.
Thank you.
Commissioner Tallarico, anything further?
No, when can I add the amendment?
When can you what?
I want an amendment, huh? Do I add an amendment to make a speed bump?
Well.
May I?
Have you opened up? You would make the amendment at the time when you're making the motion to approve the project.
Yes,
but at
yes,
this point,
no.
We'll have the public.
All right.
I neglected to say earlier, if there is anyone here that wishes to address the commission on either of these issues, if you'd be kind enough to fill out a speaker card and hand it to our staff. At this point in time, I have no cards. So could I have a motion to close the public hearing?
Motion to close.
Do I have a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Could I have a motion to adopt the findings as outlined herein?
So motion.
Do I have a second?
No, time out. Wrong. Amendment.
No. That's the conditions.
Actually,
that's the conditions coming up. We're getting to you.
He pointed at me. Okay.
Do I have a motion?
Have a motion.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Okay.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Do I have a motion to affirm the environmental assessment?
Motion to affirm.
Do I have a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
The chair will entertain a motion to approve use permit UPR 6-15-11014 and design review DR 06-15-11-15, subject to the conditions of approval as amended to include a speed bump identified herein. Do I have a motion?
Motion.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Roll call.
DiGiovanni?
Aye.
Tallarico?
Yes.
Satori?
No.
Das Magwal?
Aye.
Crump?
Aye. Moving along to use permit review, UPR 8-16-12-255 and design review, DR 08-16-12-256. Michael?
Yes, thank you, Honorable Chair, members of the Planning Commission. This is a request by Greg Ward to make modifications to an existing Chevron gasoline station at 2690 Bayshore Boulevard. Which would remove the auto repair bays that presently exist in the building and replace them with a convenience market, as well as convert a tire repair portion of the building to a drive-through car wash. So the building footprint actually is not changing, just some reshuffling and introduction of, you know, the car wash use. As indicated in the staff report, car wash use existed actually at this site in the mid, beginning in the mid-1960s, and was removed at some point, we don't know, to become the tire repair center. So just a little bit of history on the site there, in case you didn't catch it in the staff report. The site is located at the northwest corner of McDonald Avenue and Bayshore Boulevard in the city's Bayshore neighborhood, surrounded by, that's photo of the site.
Okay.
As it presently exists. We'll go into what it's surrounded by in a moment. Here are the three auto repair bays, which would be converted to the convenience store. Mm-hmm. The canopy, which is shown here, would not be changed. As a matter of fact, a lot of the architecture of the building would not largely be changed. It would be the storefront system would, of course, become a retail storefront system, but a lot of this brick would just be added to the facade. Of note in this picture are the driveway locations.
Yeah.
So some of these driveway locations are going to be changing. We'll go through that in the site plan. So we're receiving, just in terms of the public benefit of this project, better entrances to this site, as well as a lot of site changes, and we'll go through those. So in the context of the site, these are residential uses that are located directly west of the proposed car wash and the existing gas station and proposed car wash. Of note here is, again, we want to ensure that these residential uses aren't impacted by the noise that can be generated by the car wash. So we had a noise study prepared, so we'll talk about that. To the north of the site is the Prologis building. It's actually owned by Prologis, but it's San Francisco parking and traffic impound facility. So when in San Francisco your car is towed for not moving for a street sweeper or something, this is where you can pick it up.
I didn't know that.
So again, the proposal is to eliminate the existing three-bay auto repair garage in the tire service area and replace them with the 1,512 square foot convenience market and a drive-through car wash. And the drive-through car wash is on the rear side of the building. There are a number of site improvements that would occur as part of this proposal, including landscaping, driveway relocation, and the introduction of security lighting. This is the proposed site plan. And it's a little hard to read, but again, the new driveway locations are shown in the dark hashed lines. Mm. Or the existing ones are actually, just to use this one where the pointer is, existing longer? Are really close to the intersection. And so this driveway location would be moved back. This one would be moved back. And this would be shifted to better align with the parking field that exists on the site. Because right now, the driveways actually end a motorist up in the middle of the parking space. It's sort of a funky curb cut thing from the 60s or even before, actually. Of note is the westerly driveway on McDonald would actually be reduced in width to allow only an egress point.
Good.
So cars would actually not be able to enter at this location. They would only be able to exit. So the flow of traffic here is in, and it's shown in these blue arrows. Motorists, you know, who are receiving, they would pay for their car wash at the pump. It's typical at a, you know, Chevron. And then there's a pay kiosk here. As they enter the car wash at this location, they would exit through the driveway, which again is a left out, right out, but no entrance at this location. So that's the general flow. We've again worked with this applicant to try and figure out what the best flow of traffic is. The previous car wash, we think, looking at the old drawings, was the entrance was at this location and exit here. So it's not a departure from what was there some time ago. Staff's work with the applicant to introduce landscaping in the site. So we see the landscaping here. This is a generalized landscape plan. We'd receive a more detailed one, you know, upon the building permit submittal. Introduction of landscaping against the wall here with the residential use. So that's a benefit to the existing residential use to partially mitigate, you know, the introduction of the new car wash use. So that's the traffic flow that's proposed. The requirement for parking is 10 parking spaces, again, based on the numerics that are provided in the zoning ordinance. The applicants proposed 12. Of some concern to us is the location of the majority of the spaces at the rear of the property, although we do have some spaces here. So employee parking would have to occur at the rear of the property. And we've added a condition that requires some pedestrian access way through to the front. So that's something that's necessary. So that's the site plan in a nutshell. If there's any questions, of course, anybody can ask them at this point. Yes?
I would say that's great, because I have a problem with the present one at Hickey and El Camino, which is a similar thing. Food, pumps, wash. There's egress and at the same spot. This flow is a very nice thing. I like
that. It's probably the best of anyone that's come before us. And I know the one you mean. That's just a mess.
Yeah, we've reviewed a number of park or gasoline stations in the last few years, so we've gained some experience in, you know, in doing that.
Good.
Well, we have one, well, two right outside.
One
ground.
Of them is 390 Hickey.
The one that was recently redone is on a much smaller piece of property. Yeah. It works extraordinarily well. Mm-hmm. We've had no complaints from residents, even though they are immediate to the car wash. And I noticed we did put some conditions concerning the limits of operation.
Yes.
I presume the car wash that they have noted on their plan that's going to be put in is one of these that's up to standard with
it
the
is
appropriate
a modern,
noise
sure.
mitigation.
Measures. Right, and we'll talk about that in a second.
Yeah.
Mm. Here's the floor plan again. The auto repair bays would be at this location turned into the convenience retail, and the drive-through car wash would replace the tire repair at the rear of the building. Building elevations, again, a retail storefront would replace the auto repair bay openings. Pretty typical Chevron architecture. It's basically the continuation of the existing brick architecture, pretty traditional. Here's a perspective drawing that shows what the station would look like after construction. Again, pretty traditional.
It's an improvement over what's there now.
Definitely. So, yes?
I'm sorry, could you go back to that one where it shows them coming in for the car wash, the flow? Because, like I say, all right, well, they're going to come in off of the here, right, at that bottom right-hand corner. One of the problems occurring on Hickey and El Camino is five people will be waiting for a gas pump and to go, and it's out into Hickey. And that's my really, because then I'm going up to Hickey. Yeah. And is that going to occur there? You think back up out into Bayshore?
So the pumps are existing today, and okay. The applicant's proposing no more pumps than okay. exist today. So
right?
Yes, exactly. And so there's 8 fueling positions, four pumps. So to answer your question, the amount of traffic
Hickey,
would not be any increased over today. That's a very busy station
in
South San Francisco.
The answer is could.
Could, yes. Okay. All right. Thank you.
That's a very large gas station, the one that you're talking
about. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
So again, our typical use permit consideration slide, context to existing uses, site characteristics, utility, infrastructure capability. We've routed this to the affected city departments, as well as Bayshore Sanitary District, parking vehicle egress and ingress. We've discussed that. Economic development objective, of course, an upgrade to the station, is in the city's interest for an economic development perspective. Potential use impacts on site vehicle circulation. We discussed that. And car wash noise. So the car wash noise is always something that we're particularly attuned to.
Yes.
Use a pun. So the city required that the applicant prepare a noise analysis of the car wash. And so this is the noise. These are basically the noise contours. And again, the noise would be emanating from the openings of the car wash. And of note, somebody mentioned that this applicant's proposed using a muffling device that's on the car wash,
right.
And so that's been included in the noise analysis and has been added as a condition of approval. So when we take a look at what the noise would be coming from the car wash, again, the closest sensitive noise receptor, which is a residential use, is actually located at this location here. And the backyard, basically a house. Mm. And the backyard of that, where this green diamond is the noise, the sensitive noise receptor's rear yard.
Oh.
And we'll go through what the study found from that location. But generally speaking, the general plan establishes the maximum noise levels that are acceptable in the city. And we strive for between, with a use like this, not to go over 60 CNEL, community noise level. And this project does comply with that, and that's shown here. So a lot of the noise that comes out either side of this is actually going in the direction of the Prologis use, but does miss this backyard. Just so we wanted to show you why the noise study found what it did, and that's essentially shown here graphically. And this is the study's findings at various points on the project site. The quote at the bottom, and we just pulled this right from the noise study, is that the project generated noise levels within the outdoor activity area, and that's that green diamond at the back of the house of the nearest noise-sensitive receptor that residential use are predicted to be approximately 55 dBA-CNEL. So it's below the maximum acceptable noise that's allowed for a residential use. And the next slide shows what that would be in comparison to noises that we hear normally. So at the 55, it's basically at that backyard, the model shows that it would be as loud as quiet speech at that location, 55 here. So well within the blue thermometer. So with the findings of the noise study, we were able to bring the project to the Planning Commission and recommend its approval. So that's what we're doing. Staff recommends that the Planning Commission adopt the findings, affirm the environmental assessment, and recommend that the City Council approve the use permit and design review. If there's any questions, the applicants present, Mr. Greg Ward, as well as the staff, of course.
Thank you.
Commissioner Satori?
Oh, well, let the engineer handle it. Let's just approve it, because the city planner anyway is here. So let's just approve it.
Okay.
Anyway, the engineers will handle it. Okay?
Thank you for your comments.
Yes.
Rod?
No, that's not a comment. That's just my stand.
Okay. Huh? I'm with you. We'll prove it. I got to accept my professional's input.
Rod.
It's like a stupid comment.
I guess I have a question. Was there any community input from the neighbors? Was there any testimonials about
any letters?
The folks living around there?
We have received no letters on the project. Okay. So when the city conducts a public hearing like the one we're holding tonight, we do notify all of the property owners within 300 feet of the boundaries of the site. And that affords persons, and there may be somebody that still has yet to come up, but affords persons the ability to do that.
I was just kind of curious, like, what would they think?
Mm-hmm. I mean, there was no pro, no con.
Right. Okay.
And usually, if there's particularly con, we get letters.
Well, right. Commissioner Ryder, the people are quite vocal. Let me tell you, when it comes to car washes.
Yeah.
So if there was to be,
through the chair, I just wanted to make sure that our new members, as well as anyone else in the public out here, knows that this is one of those that isn't it applicable to the state law, whether you have to notify the 300 feet to notify anyone. So anyone in that house, that they definitely knew what was going on. To our members, our audience, some are here from the Bay Shore, so I want to assure them that they were notified. Thank you.
No, thank you. It's very, maybe I'll go over you guys.
I have no cards, so motion to close the public hearing.
Motion to close.
Do I have a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Could I have a motion to adopt the findings as outlined herein?
Motion to adopt.
Do I have a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Could I have a motion to affirm the environmental assessment?
I make a motion to for the environmental assessment.
Do I have a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. could I have a motion to approve use permit review UPR 816-12255 and design review DR 816-12256, subject to the conditions of approval identified herein?
Aye. All right. Motion.
Okay.
Motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Roll call, please, Tatum.
DiGiovanni?
Aye.
Tallarico?
Yes.
Satori?
Yes.
Das Magwal?
Yes.
Crump?
Aye. Do we have any public appearances, et cetera, acquisitions, vacancies, vacations? There being none, could I have a motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn.
Do I have a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
We are adjourned.
Thank you.